Hi, I'm Alexa Mehis.
And I'm Agnes Sebastian.
And now we're going to show you the new products of Christanis for 2024 winter season. So let's start with our first product, which is the Extreme Superior Gear Cover Pink. It's a perfectly new shade. From the previous season, you already know the Superior Clear Gel, which is, I think, a very popular gel because it's absolutely no heating during the curing time, and it's perfect for the no-fight technique. And now it's available in a cover pink color. The color is very nice. I think it's very similar to the most popular cover pink. Here it is. And the consistency of this gel is very good. I think it's a medium consistency, and it's absolutely perfect for no-file technique, which is also very popular now.
Can we use this product for refill?
Yes, absolutely. I really recommend it for refill, and I also recommend it for creating the whole structure of the nail, so you can build the whole nail with it.
And maybe I can make beautiful designs on it, because the cover pink has got a beautiful covering color.
Of course, yes. I think this covers very well. Comparing to the refill gels, I think this covers better than the refills.
And so maybe we can highlight the covering and the color, not?
Yes, yes. And also, what I really like in this product, that you can use it for the no-file technique. This is very popular nowadays, and we really needed something to this technique.
And I have another question. What kind of compact-based gel we can recommend underneath of this product?
Mm-hmm, this is a very good question. Because this color is a nice cover color, I would recommend some nude shade of mm-hmm. compact-based gel, for example, translucent nude, which will give some color underneath it, but not too much, so it won't change the original color of the Superior Cover Pink gel.
And can we recommend the transparent compact-based gel as well?
Yes, clear is also good. The clear is always problem underneath cover gels when you file, and maybe if you file too much, the clear will be visible underneath, but this gel is for no file technique, so this won't happen, so of course you can use the clear underneath it.
So too. Both, so translucent nude mm-hmm. and the clear.
And clear, both is good, I think.
Okay, super. Yeah. It's a nice product.
It's a beautiful color.
I like the color.
Mm-hmm.
So, and our next product is Flexi French Gel. Not just the name is beautiful, Flexi French Gel, that this is a perfect snow white and flexible product which we can use on flexible bases like gel polishes and compact base gels. And this product curing with the sticky layer, so it's sticky after the curing, but it have got an ideal consistency. It's not so hard, but it's not so fluidy, so you can work on the surface really, really easy. And of course, I can recommend you different kind of brushes to use, like my favorite zero long and zero short brush. And I think maybe the thin liner brushes, all of them are good to use and to apply this kind of product on the surface. Have you got some recommendation?
Yes, I use both of them, what you just said, but I also use Barbara 2 brush to paint on the French, because Barbara 2 is a little bit bigger than the zero. You can create the beautiful crisp smile line with it, but also when you have to paint on the rest of the free edge, it's a little bit easier with a little bit thicker brush. So I use Barbara 2 as well.
And also I can highlight something, which is, I think it's really important, that if you use this product, which is flexible, it have got a great consistency, and it will be not broken on the surface like before different other kind of products did.
Yes, absolutely. For example, Royal Gel or Highlight Gel, it's not recommended for use it for flexible bases like a compact base gel, but Flexi French is absolutely for gel polishes to have got a really nice French in this system, because it's flexible and it's not going to crack during the weeks.
And of course, we can use it on geopolished surfaces and flexible surfaces, but can we use it on artificial nails as well?
Yes, it's absolutely working, because on artificial nail, of course, it's not going to happen anything. You can use it, but I think this is the most important, that now we have something to create the French with the geopolished system.
So the most important things, that it is really homogeneous on the surface, it's snow white, it's flexible. We can say it's a kind of universal product, because you can use it on different kind of surfaces. So it is really perfect, but we have to close it, yeah?
Yes, absolutely, because it's sticky. So we have to close it with a top gel. And also, it's an important thing, the sticky layer doesn't contain any pigment, any white pigment. So when you apply the top coat on it, the top coat won't catch some pigment from the free edge and put it to the cover.
That's really
part
nice.
Of the nail. This is really good, because in this way you can create very clean and nice work.
And I think we have got just one kind of flexi French gel, which is 5 milliliters, yeah?
Yes, but I think it's enough, because the French paint on part of the nail is really small, so 4 months they can use it.
It will be long lasting.
Yes, absolutely.
So now I will speak about one of my favorite products, which is ArtGel Pro. And this is the new generation of ArtGels. And compare it with the older ArtGels, which have got creamy consistency. This is a little bit lighter product, and maybe I can say that it contains a tiny little bit more pigments than in the creamy consistency ArtGels. So I highly recommend you to paint different kind of gel paintings, but also you can use them for any kind of one move paintings as well. Really nice to use for thin lines as well, and it have got really a good coverage. So I think you can apply it underneath and on the surface of top gels, because it is curing without sticky layer like the normal art gels. So I think you will like this product.
Yes, and Agi, how many colors are we going to have?
Oh, we have got six different colors. The most important, of course, the white and the black, and of course the primary colors, which is the red, the yellow, and the blue. And next to this, we have got the green color. So these six colors you can find now
At the moment. Mm-hmm. And can we mix it with the previous art gel? To have more and more colors?
Surely. Of course, we can mix them and use them together as well. And the consistency, as I said before, it's a little bit lighter consistency. So if you mix them with the creamy consistency, the small details are adding. So you can create a nice product if you like it, because I think you use it in this way, yeah?
Yes, of course. I was asking to let everybody know about this. And I think it's a big advantage if you mix them together, because the consistency of the ArtGel Pro, I think it's better for the new painting techniques. I like it very much. And in order to get more colors, if we mix it, this very good details, this creamy consistency will add to the previous one. And in this way, I think it's really good to use. And what I feel when I paint with ArtGel Pro, I feel like my brush is just doing what it has to do on its own. It's not really easy to explain, but when you paint with it, you feel it. It's much more easier to get the homogeneous colors, and the gradients are, I think, easier to make. So I really like it. Even if I mix it, I still feel this is a better product for painting.
So what I can highlight, that it is in a jar now, not in a tube, so I think you can work more comfortable with it. So maybe if you have a really small remaining product, you can put it back, and I think it's more comfortable. And if I can tell you how much milliliters, maybe 3.
Yes, it's 3.
So even if it's 3 milliliters, I think it is really, really long lasting, because we are just using a tiny amount every time.
For me, the most exciting two new colors and new products are the Tiger Eye Infinity colors. We will have a gold and a silver color. Aggie show you the two beautiful new colors. I think we really needed these because the previous seven, Tiger Eye Infinity, was a very colorful and of course beautiful shade, but these new ones, the silver and the gold, are just one shade colors. And I think for the upcoming fall and the winter season, the Christmas season, needed these two colors, because in every single decoration, of course, we always put some gold and some silver or both of them to the holiday nails. So I'm so happy with them. And also what I really like in this new two colors, you can put underneath these shades a little bit lighter colors, such as a nude color or maybe a lighter pink. So they are working very well with lighter shades, not only with the dark ones.
And I recommend you to use this silver and gold Infinity Tiger Eye with the application together with the glass gels I have got on my nails now, that you can create different shades on the surface of the gold and the silver, and you can create a little bit bluish or pinky effect on it. So they are great. You have to try it.
And the magnets, we have to talk about a little bit which magnet we would recommend. I would say any of them. So I would recommend you to use the Multiform Tiger Eye magnet or the previous ones, the old ones. They are working very well with the Infinity, and if you have more than one magnet, you can put them next to each other in many different ways in order to get a different kind of effect on the surface of the Infinity. So I think it's worth to do some experiments with it. I think the results are amazing, doesn't matter which magnet you use.
So use your creativity and use Infinity.
So let's see what kind of three-step Crystallux we will have to the fall and winter season.
So we have got four different beautiful green colors, and I can tell you that three of them are a little bit more lighter and medium color, and the one is which is a little bit darker. And I can recommend you to use together in set with different nude colors, because they are really harmonizing well to the nude colors. And of course, I think we agree with Alexa that with the green colors, we highly recommend to use chrome colors like gold or maybe silver together.
Yes, especially for the fall and winter season, I think all the metallic colors are coming back. In summertime, we not really use it, maybe a little bit, but in wintertime, always, especially in Christmas. So I think it's really, really beautiful.
And I think you mentioned that on the darker green, the matte is really beautiful. Mm-hmm.
Yes, especially if you put some gold next to it. Mm-hmm. For example, we will tell you about later the stamping plate. We will have a really nice leaves pattern, and I would use this pattern with gold stamping lock to the green, and all of them I will apply whatever color top gel. So in this way we will have a beautiful matte effect, but still a little bit metallic.
And I think we have got more colors.
Yes, four more in the palette you can see. I think it's really hard to tell what kind of colors are these, because they are not easy to explain, because it's a little bit nudish and warm colors. I think for autumn it's perfect, and you can see the first one, the 3S137, is a little bit pinkish, but a bit darker, a little bit better, this shade for the fall season. The two in the middle, you can see they are a little bit
more brownish.
Brownish, nude colors, but yet a little bit darker. But I would recommend to use rose gold, chrome colors next to these. I think they fit very well to each other.
This is my favorite.
Yeah, and the last one is, I can't say it's red or Bordeaux or pink. I think it's something in between, but a beautiful color.
It's never enough. I think we need in the salon work different tones of Bordeaux and red colors. So this is between.
Yes, absolutely.
You need.
So in this season, we are going to have 8 different colors of 3-step Crystallux, and both group are available in a kit. In 1-step Crystallux collection, 4 new colors are available from now. 2 is a beautiful nude shade, and 2 of them is a little bit darker pink colors. For pink lovers, I think it's perfect. Of course, it's not as bright as the summer ones, but for fall and winter season, these are beautiful.
I have got more girlfriends who really love pink colors and pink shades. Now these 2 pink shades, I can tell you that after the summer pink colors, which are more vivid, these 2 is a little bit, we can tell that it's a little bit wintery colors, but I think who like pink colors, they will love them.
Absolutely. And if you like all the colors, 4 of them, you can buy all of them in a kit, in a really nice kit, so you can represent the new shades in a nice way in the box in your salon.
Who loves the nude tones, like me, one of the nude is a little bit, I can see it's a little bit more peachy and really like light nude color. And the other one, I think it's a little bit peachy, browny, but really light color. So I think you will like all of them, and you have to try them. Alexa, I know you like this pink color, but I have better, because we have got 4 new Royal Gia colors, and one of them is a beautiful pink. I know you will love it as well.
Yes, definitely.
So for the pink lovers, we have got the Royal 164, which is a beautiful, a little bit similar pink to the 3-step color. So who likes the pink? Now we have that.
Yeah, I just found it. Beautiful.
It's a little bit more wintry color, not so vivid like the summer pink colors. And next to that, we have got another little bit darker tone, which is a blue color. It's like a king blue, I can say, yeah? It's a darker blue color. I think it's beautiful with gold and silver color together. And next to these 2 colors, we have got 2 colors which are light colors. One of that is Royal 162. It's a beautiful little bit grayish bluish color, but really light, and I know you will love it. And the other one is a baby pink color. So who likes the pink? Maybe you can put together the 2 pink color together, but this pink, I think it have got a little bit peachy feeling.
Just wanted to say I would use them together. I would choose the gray and the blue together, mm-hmm. and the darker pink and the lighter pink together.
That's a great idea.
I think they fit very well. Look at these beauties in front of me. These are our new moisturizing hand, body and foot lotions. 2 new scents are available. The one in the left is the Oriental Jasmine. I think this is for the flower scent lovers. And on the right side, you can see the Royal Ritual scent, which is a little bit
fruity,
yes, and also fresh. So, but I think both of them is really great. But of course, somebody likes the flowery scent, and another person maybe likes this one better.
The more
fruity.
Fresh.
Yes,
the fresh,
fresh and
scent,
fruity.
Yeah.
The sizes are the same. 250 milliliters are the big one, and the small ones are only 30 milliliters.
Those are really cute.
Yes, and the The whole package is new because now the last drop can come out from the package because it's a pump package now. So I think it's really good for keeping these in your small bag. And also I would give these to my clients for a present, maybe for Christmas. I always do that every single year. And why we like this, it's moisturizing very well, so I think it's a really nice and rich cream, but it's paraben, sulfate and silicone free.
And SLS and PEG free.
Yes, and I think it's really important nowadays because everybody tries to be a little bit more, sensitive about what you're applying to your skin, and if you use these products, you will use products without these five very damaging ingredients. So I would highly recommend them to use it on your own and to give it away to your clients.
Definitely, I will try it. And we have got fantastic news because we have got four different packages from the One Step Colors, the Three Step Colors and the Royal Gels.
Yes, the Royal Gels are here, you can see them. The boxes, all of the kits boxes can redo in a way in order to represent the new colors in a display. You can see here are the Royal Gels, and also we can do the same from the box of the gel polishes. You have to take this part out and also take out the bottles, put it back and you close it. And also we have this part comes here. This is really nice. And you can just easily put back the colors here. So in this way, if you want to show the whole collection to your client, I think this is a really nice way to do it.
Definitely.
Yes. And I don't know if you already read the name of these kits, because after these really difficult months because of this coronavirus, we wanted to give such names like Stronger Together, Keep Calm,
Heal the World, and Spread Love.
And Spread Love, yes. This is like a little message from us to our customers, and we try to give you some positivity. And also I think the colors are really nice, calm, and also I think they are giving some positivity because they are warm colors, most of them. So this is how we thought maybe it would be a nice thing to do.
And which sizes we have in the kits?
From the Royal Gels, they are 4.5 milliliters, and all of the gel polishes are 4 milliliters in the kit.
So they are the smaller sizes?
Yes, yeah? They are the smaller sizes.
That's great.
So let's continue and see what kind of decoration products we're going to have in this season.
Yeah!
Our favorite, right? So first is the transfer foil set. I think the transfer foil sets were really popular in the previous seasons. And of course, there is so many different kind of pattern. So of course, we could choose a new one, which is a marble set. And I opened the box. Can see how many beautiful marble effect foils are in
they
here.
They are just amazing in color.
Yes, and if you see the colors, you can find the trend and decor colors, really similar ones. For example, I would use to the green three steps, this one, or maybe even these. And I would put the two lighter marble effect foil to the nude colors of the One Steps, or if you want to do some cooler kind of design, I would choose this one or that one to the Royal Gels, to the gray and to the bluish one. Yeah, so I think for all of them we can find a very good match in the marble foil set. And Aggie, how would you use them? What do you think?
I have got different ideas because when I see them, I start to use my creativity, and in my head there are some designs with magic stripe sticker, you know, the rose gold and the silver and the gold one, which you can curve if you want, and I think they are really looks amazing together, so let's try to do some designs from that. And I think this kind of foil is really good working on the whole surface, yeah?
Yes.
And we just mentioned with Alexa that it's beautiful if you use a little bit on a bigger surface on the nails.
Yes, because the pattern is visible only if you use it in bigger surface or the full surface. If you want to apply to the whole surface of the nail, we would recommend to use the Profoil gel underneath it.
And is it possible to use it on the total surface perfectly?
Yes, yes, yes. Of course, because of the surface
curvy,
it's a little bit difficult to apply it perfectly smoothly. But of course, there will be some lines, but still they will close the whole surface because the pattern is a marble effect. I won't say the lines will be,
not visible.
No. I think we will have a feeling that it's the design. The line, so I don't think it's bothering. And
do we have to close it?
Yes, with a top gel, definitely. And I would say if your clients use the hand very much and they have got a job, for example, what they do with their hands, I would say apply two top coat on it, and in this way.
You mean two layers?
Yeah, yeah. Two layers of cool top, and I would say in this way it's 100% long lasting.
Perfect. And we have got a new member in the family of the stamping plates. And especially it is designed with wintery design, and we have got different kind of leaves on it.
Yes, this is why it's called fallen leaves, because in autumn time, of course, the leaves are the most emphasized motifs in the designs. And yes, leaves, pumpkins.
And you have got a favorite, yeah?
Yes, I got my favorite with the little pumpkins on it, because for Halloween I think it would be really good. And also I have some favorites in which is a more wintery Christmassy design, such as the pine tree or the mistletoe, and there are the rose hip pattern as well. I think it's really nice for the winter time too. Let's continue with more and more decoration products, our favorites. These are in my hand five different kind of nail art sticker. They are really nice designs, especially for the fall season. You can find many different kind of leaves. Three sticker contains leaves only, but very different kind of leaves. We have one which is the classic classic autumn leaves, because they are really colorful, yellow, red and brown colors we can find. But there are two which is, I think, they are more modern, they are a little bit more how to say, maybe sophisticated, because you can see the designs are a little bit different than the real fall leaves.
This is actually my favorite, which is a little bit more pastel colored, and the other one is a little bit more vivid.
Yes, and darker tones.
I think it's a little bit more tropical, and that's one a little bit more autumn and a little bit more softer colored.
Yes, and we have two other ones. They are very colorful and nice and sweet designs we can find in here. We can find leaves as well, different kind of than the previous ones. And we can find foxes, rabbit, ladybirds or pumpkin, and maybe some flowers also, roses, because the rose hip, I think there is also can be found. And I think it's really nice and sweet. We can find some mushrooms now. And because these are also, I think, represent this season, so now we can have a decoration with mushrooms also.
And how can we use this kind of sticker? I mean, can we use it with simply with a tweezer, or do we need to dip in water?
Yeah, no, we don't need to dip it into the water. We just take the sticker from the paper with a tweezer.
Yeah, and it's easier to apply.
Yes, because it's sticky on their own, and I would recommend to put them on a dry surface. This is really important
because shiny.
Shiny is better, but if the surface is matte but really smooth and even, it's still fine. Mm-hmm. But if it's rough, if the scratches of the file are visible in the surface, it's not really good. They are not sticking very well to that surface. But for example, if you use matteware before and you want to stick the sticker to the matteware, they will work. But the best, the very best, is the shiny and non-sticky surface.
Why we don't recommend on the sticky layer?
Because of the adhesive part of the sticker can stick into the sticky layer, because the sticky layer separates the surface and the sticker from each other, so in this way they can stick very well.
Maybe it can a little bit moving on the
surface.
Yes,
and moving also, and maybe part of it sticks and another part will come up, and it's really annoying. So I would recommend you to seal these products, for example, with Kooltop, or another good solution, if you use the, for example, 3-step and it's sticky after curing, just clean it with a cleanser and then you can stick the design on it. But this is why I like the 1-step colors, when I know that I will use stickers or, for example, chrome powders, I always work with 1-step colors because they are not sticky after curing and I can work directly on this surface.
Yes, that's a good idea. Mm-hmm. It's more easy to use them.
Yes.
What are you doing, Alexa?
Oh, sorry, I'm pinching because I just found this new pinching tweezer here in the table. This is called the Shape X. The X is because it forms an X, actually. And this tweezer is a very strong one, and I really recommend it to use when you work with parallel shapes, because the previous tweezer what we've got, you remember that one?
Yeah.
This comes in quite well. And
it's a little bit narrowing.
Yes, it's narrowing, absolutely narrowing. But this one narrows a little bit, but not too much. You can see this part of it, the button, is quite parallel, and I would use this one to square or for pipe nails and every single shape which requires this kind of pinching. But I would say I wouldn't use it for base layer when you work with gel, because you know it's really thin, the base layer, and this tweezer is quite strong, and I wouldn't use it in the previous part of the nail building. But in the end, when you are finding, for example, the smile line and you fill the free edge with some kind of color, for example, white, you're making a French nail, I would put this on the free edge and ask my client to put it into the lamp with the tweezer on it, because actually it stays quite well on the nail. So I think for this part of the job, it's perfect.
Are you recommend for any kind of material?
Yes, I think the acrylic and the acrylic gel is okay if you use this tweezer, because the method is a little bit different. For example, if you work with acrylic, maybe you pinch the whole nail in the end only, and there are enough product and it's hard enough to deal with a strong tweezer like this. But when you work with gel and you build your nail layer by layer, the first one layer or two layer is quite thin, and it's maybe it will crack or it hurt mm-hmm. the client, because this tweezer is really strong.
So you can use it for fusion gel and normal gel as well.
Yes, absolutely, but you have to decide which part of the work you're picking this up and use it.
Definitely, I will try it. And now, here is the new Extreme Fusion Actual Gear Reverse Tip, which is a new and reusable package. It's a little bit bigger size because now it is 140 pieces. And it's really great because you can reuse them after the application. And as I know, we have got two different shapes of them.
Yes, yes, we have this regular shape what we have before, but now we will have two new sizes because two sizes were missing, and the other one is an almond shape reverse box because for almond shape nails we need a little bit different curves, so from now on we can do the almond shape with the reverse technique as well.
And I think what has changed, the curve of the tips, it's a little bit changed because now it's more passing to the natural nail plate or the natural curve of the nail plate, yeah?
Yeah, so it's easier to use it and maybe more client natural curve fits to the tip now.
They are flexible, yeah?
Yes, they are very flexible. This is why we can reuse them after, because it's not only one time how we use it, because we can just take it out easily. The shape of the tip stays completely the same. So in this way, we have to put it back to the box and we can use it many times.
And what can we do with them? I mean, can we do French nails or design nails in one step?
Yes, yes, it's possible. Of course, it depends on what kind of acrylic gel you use and how you use it. For example, you can use white and cover pink in order to get a French nail. I think maybe baby boomer is possible as well if you create a nice gradient. And if you want, you can do some designs. You can build in, for example, some glitters, nail fatty, and many different things, whatever you want actually. You can put it into the reverse tip and apply some clear or transparent fusion acrylic gel. And in this way, the design will be there too. In the finished nail.
I think it's a great idea because it makes our salon work maybe faster.
Yes,
yeah?
Even faster. The reverse technique, it's a fast technique, but if you build in designs with it, it's super fast.
As I can see, those tips are quite long. I recommend to make long nails with it or just medium or shorter?
I think it depends on the natural nail shape. Because the tips are curved, and if the shape is it fits very well, maybe if you don't need to bend the tip down in order to have a nice shape, you can use it for longer nails. If you have to bend it too much, of course the long nail will be go down, which is not really nice and we don't recommend it. In this case, you have to use it for shorter or maybe medium. Long is only possible, I think, in cases where the natural nails grow quite straight. So in this way, a little curve can still work with a longer shape.
Super. I think we know everything about it.
Yes, absolutely.
The new metal cases, which you can see here, they are just beautiful, and I will speak about all the details of them. As you can see, they are not just designful, but they are really, really useful because inside and outside they are changed. And probably everybody was thought about that what kind of suitcase you can choose for you to our job. As you can see, they are 3D decorated, and inside it is really, really changeable, and it is really creative. You can put any kind of product inside, you will see. So now I will present for you the new suitcase, which is the large trolley case. And this is my favorite, the baby pink. As you can see, it is approximately two size bigger than the previous was. And it contains three different size parts. The lower part, it is the highest one. The medium part is the lowest, and the upper part is similar size than the medium suitcase. And everybody gets a beautiful present, which is an extra lid that you can apply on the lower two parts, so you can create different variations to the suitcase. And on the top, this is the top part, the upper part. So on it, you can apply an extra handle, a shoulder handle, so you can remove it or you can use with it. But if you make different variations, you have the possibility to put it on your shoulder, and the lower one or two parts with the top, you can create different sizes, and you can make a separation, so this you can use it on your shoulder, and the other two with the handle you can roll with you. So as you can see, the rolling is really easy now, because this new trolley get two extra wheels, so now it have got four wheels, and because of these four wheels you can move very very easy, and you can turn around completely now. So this is really new, because the previous can do this, and it's really easy to move with you, really comfortable, so I think everybody will love it. And what I have to tell you, and this is my favorite, this small extra part, which is a removable drawer, pull-out drawer, and inside of this you can put, for example, extra UV lamp, LED lamp, or for example extra things without opening this part. I think it's really useful, and you will see inside is really creative, because you can create many possibilities to pack your things inside, so I'm sure you will love it. So, and I have got an extra information, which is really important, that if I turn around, you can see this extra handle, which is also, the size is changeable, as you can see, but it contains an extra belt the previous haven't got. And the extra belt, because of the extra belt, the weight distribution is much better, and the stability and the durability of the trolley will be much, much better, so you can do any kind of movement. If you want, you can turn the suitcase, you can turn around, of course, but because of this small belt, it will be extra long-lasting and durable. So let's see some creative solutions how you can apply the brick trolley case. As you can see, it have got the upper part, which is can be used alone, so if you open here with these two small part, you can see it have got the shoulder handle, which you can apply on your shoulders. And it have got two lower parts and the extra lid, which you can apply on the top. So in this case, you can use different ways. You can get a medium size, or if you use just this medium case, you can use it alone. I think it's really cute. Or if you apply the lid, the extra lid on the top of the lower part, you can create a little bit higher but a bigger case. So this is another solution. And of course, if you have got really heavy things in this lower part or lower and medium part together, I recommend you to separate these two parts, so you can apply the upper part on your shoulder, and you can bring with you, with this rolling movement, the lower one or two parts. So I think it is really creative. You can apply in many ways, so use your fantasy, and you will see it is really good, and you can pack all your stuff inside. Finally, I can open the box. So if you open with these two clips, you can see I've got the left and the right parts, On the right part there is a two-parted tray, and on the left side there is just one, because it is a little bit higher one, and you can pack here many Gelax, for example, Crystalax inside, because the height is a little bit higher than on the right side. On the right side, I think the sizes are perfect for the small jars, the smaller, the medium, and the bigger jars as well, but I will show you. But let's see from the bottom, and you can see every trays have got a small part on the bottom, which is a transparent small layer. It is good because you can clean your box easier because of that. And I think it's important because if you bring with you stuff like gels, for example, you have to clean it easier. I think everybody knows that. So, on the bottom, you can apply different things. I will give you good ideas about it. For example, of course, you can put the paper towel in this way. And if you have got smaller sizes, LED or UV lamps, of course, you can put here easier, or you can put and you can pack your drill machine here. I have to tell you, and I have to show you, that the bottom part contains two small divider plates. You can remove them, or you can use them in different ways. So you can separate them a little bit wider parts or thinner parts, but you can use your fantasy and you can be creative. So what else we can put here? Yes. It's a good thing that in a vertical position you can put, for example, the creams, you can put the bigger sizes of, for example, the cleanser inside, not the biggest one, but the medium size. And for example, the soft nail wipes, which is also important to bring with you. So there are different products which is not good if they are a little bit in a turned position in the bottom. So the medium sizes are really good in this part. And for example, why not? You can pack your favorite small cases like that in the bottom part. Okay, let's see what we can put here. I recommend you here the Crystalax, for example, the three-step, the one-step, for example, different sizes, the bigger and the smaller top gels, like Cool Top. And it's really good that in the vertical position you can pack them inside, but you can see there are different separation panels inside that you can use creatively. If you remove one or two, for example, you can do different shapes. And if you put it back, you can apply the products different way. Or simpler, you can just remove all of them and you can pack lot of Crystalax inside next to each other. But let's see, if you created different sizes, for example, you can pack in the smaller one two Gelax, two Crystalax, and in the longer ones, you can put your favorite art gels as well. And of course, your favorite creams, the lower and a little bit higher one. So you don't need to worry about this one, because if you close the box, you have got here a small, I don't know, maybe a few centimeters height. So it's possible to close with this. But you can apply here extra things, but on the other side, I show you, also you can remove the small panels. You can put it here, or you can simply just remove them. And in this plate, you can put your favorite files, because the size is just like that. So it's really comfortable. For example, you can put your UV bulbs inside or LED, or maybe the head of the drill machine. Okay, what else we can put? If you have got favorite stamping plates, you can put here. And my favorite, the upper part, because we have got different sizes of jars. For example, about the gels. The gel products, the bigger one, two sizes, the bigger sizes are possible to put here. Even if it's higher, as I showed you before, it is possible to close it, so don't worry about it. The medium size, it is possible to put two different sizes. And our favorite product, or one of our favorite products, is the Royal Gel. So these jars, three of these jars, it is possible to put next to each other precisely. So we can close it like that. And just another idea, if you want, we have got this holder, so we can apply and we can pack it here. Or if we haven't got higher sizes, we can put it on the top. But later I will show you another option, which is a little bit better, where to put this holder, the brush holder. So I think, let's see the other ones, the lower ones. So the cutest part is coming with the medium part, as you can see, if I open with the small extra lid. You can see this part is the lowest part, but it's optionally, of course, what you can put inside. But I recommend you to pack your stuff like three-step, one-step Crystallux or Topshine gels, because it's really fit inside. Of course, those divider panels can be removed, and you can change them as you wish, but I really recommend you to pack your smaller stuff, like of course your Gelax and Crystallax top gels. And of course, it's really important if you make a structure, for example, the biggest jars of gels. I will show you, if you put one, it's okay, but if you put two on the top of each other, it's also fit in it. So after, if you close it with the extra lid, it is perfect inside, because the extra lid, you have got an extra 5 centimeter highness. So even if you put two big jar on the top of each other, it is perfect. And of course the medium size, two on each other. And of course, if you want, you can create a little bit more slimmer shapes, and you can pack your Royal gels inside, or maybe your stuff like acrylic powders, for example. So many things, but I recommend you to put inside those smaller things. Of course, if you remove all of them, or a little bit change the shape, you can put your drill machine inside, but I think the machines are a little bit better in the biggest part below. So, of course, really important, we use many times nail form. The nail form is perfect inside, and I think these most important things inside like that, you can pack, you can put on the top the extra lid. But I show you an extra thing, that our most important thing, the brushes, you can put on the top of the biggest jar. So it's not a problem if you put two of those biggest jar, you can put the brush holder on the top, and in this case you can close perfectly as well the top. I close it, and if I want, I can use it alone. So now this exciting part is coming. I will open the lid again. And let's see the lowest part. There are many, many spaces here, so you can put your stuff in this this part. And I think what is really important to show that here you can put your highest or biggest stuff, like for example skincare products, or for the pedicurist girls, there is the spa products. They are a little bit higher, so we need space here for the cleanser as well, because it's a really important product, the big cleanser, because we are using a lot. And for example, one of the biggest product is the easy remover. You can pack it easily. And of course, there are many, many places. So maybe if you want, you can put here again your maybe your second brush holder. Why not? Or you can put extra things, for example, your colors. There are many, many possibilities. And of course, this part contains again this divider plates, which you can remove or change. And I will show you. I have got a small idea, because if you make a little bit bigger part, you can put your drill machine here. Of course, the drill machine can be packed in the upper part, but here as well. And of course, there is another important stuff, the paper towel. You can put here in this position. And of course, you can pack your smaller things, like the towel here, and some extra things. Okay, we can close it. And my favorite is coming now, because we have got an extra drawer here, and I will open it to show what you can put here. Many, many things, of course. There are separation panels here. You can use them, you can change them as you want. And if you use them, it is possible to put this medium-sized product, like the cleanser, which is the 100 milliliter cleanser, and for example, this kind of skincare products. And if you remove them, I will do it fastly, you can put here a bigger UV lamp, the crystal lamp, so there is enough space to put this kind of lamp inside. So it fits perfectly, and I think it's really good to put here, because when you pack your things, you can remove it easily and more fastly. So you don't need to open everywhere your boxes, just easily you pull out, and there is your lamp or your most your favorite products, for example. So it's really fast and practical to use. So I hope you get many, many ideas. I really love this trolley, but let's see the others. So let's open the medium box. If you open it, you will see it's really, really similar to the big trolley's upper part. But what is a little bit different, that this box is a little bit slimmer and a little bit higher. So with this shoulder band, if you use it and you bring with you, because it's a little bit slimmer, it's more comfortable on your side. Let's open it. So if I open, you will see it's perfectly the same than the big trolley's upper part, but because it's a little bit slimmer, those trays are also a little bit slimmer. But don't worry about it, because the same products you can fit inside. So as I mentioned before, all of the trays contains this small plastic layer on the bottom, and of course you can clean them really easily. And the separation panels are also changeable. So now I will do something. For example, let's see, I create a little bit smaller and bigger separated parts. I will put it back. So in this way, I can put smaller and bigger stuff. For example, I really like to put here the Sokov gels, like three-step and one-step Crystallux, or I really like to put here the top gels. I can put a lot inside. And in the bigger parts, as I showed before, art gels, those are my favorites. I can put them, maybe color by color, so lighter color, darker colors. And the other side is really interesting because it have got two parts. A little bit, the lower part is of course lower, and here the upper part you can put a little bit higher products and bigger products. I will show it. I really recommend to remove those parts because in this case you can put your stuff like files or buffers inside, and any other things which are a little bit longer. And for example, to the upper side, you can pack bigger stuff. For example, gel jars, which is the biggest size. You can put two of them next to each other, comfortable. And here, if you remove a little bit, you can pack three of the Royal gels next to each other, precisely. And in the middle, it will be a remaining small part for extra things like, effect powders, for example, which are smaller a little bit. So I think in this way, you can pack really, really comfortable and clever. Okay, if you close them, one of our most important stuff is the brush holder, with the brushes, of course. And with the brush holder, we can open or close comfortable the box. Okay, but let's see the bottom, what we can put and what we can place in the bottom. In the bottom part, we have got separation panels. It is changeable, you can remove them, you can change the directions. And what is really important, I think, in this box, if you want to go to a course, for example, or just work somewhere, you can pack every important stuff what you need for the work. Of course, it is a medium box, so you cannot put everything in it, but the most important things that you need, for example, the drill machine, the UV lamp or LED lamp, or the stuff that you use, are possible to put just in this medium box. Okay, so let's see. Our important product is the LED lamp or the UV lamp. I think this lamp is a medium size, so this is not the biggest size lamp. I think it's comfortable to put in this size of box, so you can put it inside. And of course, in a vertical position, you can put your paper towel comfortably, your cleanser, for example, maybe a skincare product if you want. And if you want, you can put extra stuff like nail form inside. And what I almost missed, the drill machine. So you can see we can pack here every important stuff. And now I can close my box. I almost forgot. And now let's go to work. Let's see the small cute cases. I will open this baby pink box because I would like to show you good options and variations how you can pack your box easily. This case is good when you don't want to bring so much stuff with you. Compared it with the last box, it is a little bit higher and a little bit slimmer. So, in this case, you can put your cleanser inside, which is really important because in the previous box, it was not possible to put the cleanser just in a turn position, what is not really good because maybe it was opening or a little bit vaporizing and it's not so good. But now, in this box, it is possible to put easier your cleanser or maybe your little bit medium-sized stuff like skincare products. And of course, you can close it easier. And the other things, you can put many gel lac or top gels inside. Or if you change a little bit the inside part, I will show you how. You can pull out and you can change the position easily. And in this case, you can put bigger gel jars, maybe two on each other. And of course, after you can close it and you will have a remaining 5 centimeter part. So on the top, you can put other things. Okay, for example, you can put smaller jars like royal gels on the top of each other and next to each other. So in this way, they will not falling away. I will open another box, my favorite red box. Look at that, so much things inside. So, if you want, put this beautiful Aurora case. You can put inside your favorite effect powders or glitter powders, for example. You can put your palette, or you can put your transfer foils. There is enough space to put your tip fix. Of course, spray prep or the cleanser. Really important, for example, a fusion gel, a smaller or bigger package, a cream, hand cream, and a few soak off gel. There is enough space. So can you see, even if it's a really small bag, you can put many things. And what is my favorite? On the top, you can put, for example, a few files or brushes as well. And you can close it easier.
Our last product are the new diaries for the next year. I think they are beautiful. What do you think, Agi?
I don't know which is my favorite, really. Maybe this one.
Yes, it's really difficult to choose between them. One is really nice and lighter colors with
aquarelle style.
Yeah, aquarelle style and with flowers. And the other one, I think it's the party diary or something.
That's for me.
Yes, this is a super hollow pink color, like such as the, you know, the chrome powder is the same effect. Let's see what's inside. I think it's really good. This is a new thing in the diary that you can easily take out the middle.
Ah, so it's changeable.
It's changeable, yes. Maybe if you want to keep it for next year, you can keep it. But if you like both designs, you can buy all of them. And easily you can just take out this part of the diary and maybe in springtime you use this, but in summertime you want to use this, so you can do that too. And let's see, we have some pictures in it, step by steps, and different designs. Oh, this is also my favorite.
Small inspirations.
Yes, yeah, yeah? Small inspirations. You can see, you can fill in your personal details. You can see that you can check the whole year. And let's see how the week looks. You can see from 6 in the morning. Wow. You can work until until 10:30 in the evening.
For the fanatic.
Yeah, for the fanatics. What I also like in this diary, there are some pockets in the back and in the front as well, so you can keep your maybe name invoices, name cards, yes, many important things. And here is some little
holder for the pen or for the pencil,
which is also a good thing. So I think this diary will be my favorite this year. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you're going to like the Crystalness products as much as we do.
Try them, use them, and make great Crystalness compositions. Bye bye.
Bye bye.